Hello and welcome to Teacher's Room, the show that's by teachers for teachers. I'm Dan.
And I'm Sean, and this episode's topic is...
No teacher is perfect.
Not even Dan.
Not even Dan. All teachers have bad habits, but being a good teacher means reflecting on your teaching practice and trying to improve it. So...
here are three bad habits that many teachers do. So make sure you don't.
That's right. And please note that all the examples in this program are bad examples.
Don't copy us. The first bad habit is too much TTT.
That's teacher talking time.
For example, you set a task and then you go on and on giving more and more examples.
Or you ramble off into another conversation and forget the task entirely.
Yes, stop.
Stop it.
Don't do it.
As a rule, a class should have a minimal teacher talking time input.
Yeah.
Something around
70-80% student.
30-20
teacher.
Now, an example would be, I used to be fat. Actually, you know, I did used to be fat. You know what happened? It was in secondary school because she bought me an ice cream. Oh, guys, that's break time. Our next bad habit is echoing.
Echoing.
Stop it.
This is when you repeat exactly what the students have said.
Yeah, now this might be done to clarify what they've said.
Yeah, or to make sure the rest of the class have heard.
Or to reassure the student themselves that you understood what they just said. But whatever reason you have for doing this,
don't do it.
You are undermining their ability
to communicate. Yeah, it's showing the class that only the teacher has value and that we have to listen to the teacher, not each other.
Exactly. So if you didn't understand the student, tell them and ask them to repeat.
Yeah, and if you think they spoke too quietly and the rest of the class didn't hear, just say, speak up, say it again.
If you did understand what they said, why aren't you responding normally anyway?
Yeah.
That's how conversation works, right?
That's how conversation works, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stop it. Okay, Sean, tell me something you used to do.
I used to play rugby.
So you used to play rugby? Oh, I used to play rugby. Our third bad habit is not admitting when you've made a mistake. Now, this may surprise you, but teachers are human and we make mistakes too.
We make mistakes, don't
exactly.
we, Dan?
Mm.
So, maybe you've written a word incorrectly on the board.
Maybe you've explained a grammar rule completely wrong.
Maybe a student's asked you a question and you don't know the answer.
Whatever it is, don't bluff.
No, don't pretend you know the answer. Don't tell them it wasn't a mistake.
It's only going to make your students lose confidence in you. You tell them when they make a mistake, do them the same respect.
Exactly. Mm. So if you don't know the answer, go and find out. Report back later.
Or you can make a joke out of it and say, I was just checking to see if you were paying attention or not.
That's yeah, right. You've done that.
And those are the forms of used to. Yes, Sean.
But I think in negative and question, there's no D.
No, there is a D because in the affirmative form we have a D, and so in the negative form we must have a D.
But my teacher, and
in
my book...
listen, verbs don't change form when they're in the negative. Don't worry about that.
Right, that's enough about what not to do. Mm. We want to hear what we should do in the classroom.
So send us a video tip by going to our website, bbclearningenglish.com, to find out how to get it to us.
And you may get a t-shirt. Where's
you may
t-shirt?
Indeed get a t-shirt. There they are. Bam!
Okay.
All right.
I think that's it.
That's it, isn't it? Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Don't do that again.